In my previous video, we have understood how to add 1-bit numbers using the adder circuit. In this video, I'm going to tell you how we can use the same circuit and add more complex numbers. Not just that, I would also tell you how to convert that circuit into a Java program. Let's explore. Let me begin by getting back my adder circuit. While this circuit can perform addition, the disadvantage is that it can add only single bit numbers. It cannot add longer numbers. Now, how do I make this add longer numbers? Well, as a programmer, I have devised a logic for it, and these four steps would help this circuit not just to add single bit numbers, but to add even longer numbers. Let me consider the integers 5 and 3. 5 in the binary form is like this, whereas 3 in the binary form is like this. I want to perform the addition of 5 and 3. Using this circuit, using the logic, I would be able to perform. How? Watch it. I would expand this 5, I would expand 3, and as you can see, the least significant bits happen to be 1 and 1, which I consider them as my input 1 and the input 2. My first step says that I should XOR input 1 and input 2 to obtain the sum. After all, that is what the circuit also says. So, I will XOR 1 and 1 and I'll get the sum as 0. Hope you recollect yesterday's truth table, the way XOR behaves. My second step says that I will have to AND my input 1 and input 2 and obtain the carry. So, when I'll AND 1 and 1, I am going to get the carry as 1. That is what even the circuit says. Hope you realize that the first two steps is exactly what the circuit is saying. But here is a larger challenge. That in the next cycle, I am supposed to add my new input 1, my new input 2, as well as the old carry. Which means I am supposed to perform addition of 3 digits. Well, this circuit cannot perform 3-bit addition. All that it can perform is a 2-bit addition. So how do I add these 3 bits? Well, that is where you have to use your logical thinking. As a programmer, I have devised my third step, which says that I am going to add input 1 and input 2 and temporarily store the result back in input 1. So, I will apply this on my inputs. I will add 0 and 1, and you know the result happens to be 1, which I will keep it back in input 1. And then I will apply my fourth step, which says that I just have to left shift my carry and consider that as input 2. And that rule, when I'll apply, my carry is going to be considered as input 2. And now you can notice that I just have to add the next 2 bits that are there. And for that, I will have to repeat these 4 steps. So, when I'll apply the first step, I get the sum. When I'll apply the second step, I get the carry. When I'll apply the third step, I am temporarily adding the 1 and 0 and I am getting the result as 1. And when I'll apply the fourth step, carry comes in as input 2. What next? Again, I need to repeat these steps. So, when I'll apply the first step, that is the case. Second step, that is the 1. Third step, and the fourth step. And when I'll repeat it again, this is what happens. So, we have got the output. The output happens to be 1000, which is 8. I've been successful in adding 5 and 3 without using any addition operator. As you can see, I have used the XOR to perform addition and I have used the AND to give me the carry. So, what you have understood through this video is how you can convert this simple adder to also add larger numbers with the help of this logic. Of course, still what is not known is how to convert this logic into a Java program. For that, you have to wait for my next video.